are you doing? I put up a cover a little while ago, if there's no other way. And I've had a few emails. People have asked me to send the tab. I don't use tab, I play by ear, which is why people criticise me for having mistakes and stuff in my songs. But I thought it might be an idea just to put up a quick lesson on how to play There's No Other Way, which is just a huge tune. And really does look like quite a good one if you can pull it off, but it's actually quite straightforward. Now, there's quite a few chords in it, but really and truly the whole thing lives in about three or four sections. So what we'll do is just break it down and then take you through each little bit of it, one stage at a time. And then hopefully from there you'll nail it. Alright, first thing to see, obviously it's capoed. If you want to play along with the record, at least in that key, it's capoed at the second, alright? So you've got a capo second fret. But what I'll do is I'll just talk about the chords as if you were playing on an open neck, so you know, D, C, and so on and so forth, okay? Right, so the first section is the famous intro, which has that big long slide. And then slides it and back, way back down. So that's however you want to play it. I personally go with the D string really on my ring finger. Now what you want to do is slide up to the 12th fret, right? Even with the capo, still the 12th. So whatever that would be, ordinary would be the 10th, wouldn't it, on an ordinary guitar? So just up to the 12th, and then it's a bar across the 14th. So you're barring the 12th there. And then bar on the 14th, and then slide all the way back down again, and it's bar on the 1st, and the 3rd. So put the whole thing together, it's like that. And Graham Coxon plays really sort of staccato rhythmic style, lots of sort of scrapes in his playing, so that's not, it's not straight, it's more of a... like that, alright, so then the last part of that section is a G chord, which is just played a sort of partial G, so you're on the B, the G and the D string. You can get that. And then a little hammer on the 7th fret there with your little finger, make sure you can see that. So it's like, so as you come up it goes, and that's that intro section, and that repeats I think four times at the intro, and there's after the first verse I think it goes on another four times as well. I can't remember if it pops up again in this song, but you get the idea. Okay, so cool, so we've got that, and then the main part of the verse is really straightforward chord progression. It's D, A, D, C, major, A, and up, slide up and down to the to a D chord, back down to A, and then finishes on the C. And I'll play it through quickly, first of all. So it's a little bit like this. Alright, so just breaking it down, so ordinary D major, ordinary C major, but with a hammer on the B string on your index finger, and then straight into an A with the A with in the same beat with the A sort of quite quickly on the I guess on the 16th. I'm not particularly big on music theory, but you just slide that up to the 7th fret, or it'll be the 5th on your capo, but either way, and then back down again, and then play the open strings, fingers off all together, and back onto a C with a hammer on again. So, and so that little open string to the second C is a bit tricky just to get the feel and the rhythm right, but well worth persevering with. Okay, so. And that's a verse. Now the chorus is quite similar. It starts off with a D major. And then goes into what I think is C added ninth or C, I can't remember. It's like basically a power chord. So from the D, come off the D, leave your index, your ring finger where it was in the D, and then use your first and second fingers to form the root notes of C. And if you want, you can add your little finger to the E string to give this chord. Or you can take your finger off with a sort of more esoteric sound. I'm not quite sure how he plays it in the song, but either one of those will work. So it's D to C, and then straight around to an ordinary F chord. And the repetition of that phrase. And then back to a D. And then throughout the verse, when you return to the D, you add your little finger for that, whatever that is, D suspended, 7th, added 7th, I can't remember now, but and run around that loop goes. Now, at the end of the verse, Coxon plays this little phrase, so it comes, will come off the ends up on the D, and that's simply from leaving your index finger on. So a little stretch here, so it's, so on the G string you've got the 2nd fret and the 5th fret, and then come down to this arrangement, which would be 2nd finger on the D string at the 3rd and index finger on the G string at the 2nd, so. And then slide that whole thing up 2 frets. And a little hammer on there. And then, depending where you are in the song, it's either back to your slidey bit or straight back into the verse again. So that's the three main sections of the song, and of course all that's left now is the coda, the little outro, and that's just simply followed by chords. So one at the 12th, which I still think of as an E, it's not the capo, but you get the idea. And then again down to, I think, is it the 10th? The 10th. And that repeats 4 times, but there are hammer-ons and pull-offs in that that you need to really, if you're going to really nail it, you need to learn those. So the first chord, that E major at the 12th, you're hammering on and pulling off with your second finger, so just really taking it from a major to a minor very quickly. And then on that second chord there, which is, I don't know, it's a D, isn't it, really, if you had no capo. You have a D, I suspend your thing, where you just, you could take your little finger off and do it that way, but I just prefer to slam it really and just go for that Kaiser Chiefs tone, and then straight B. And that's it, there's no other way, that's how you play No Other Way. And that's pretty much how it's recorded. There are a couple of, if you listen carefully to the song, sort of random ends of verses, starts of choruses, there are some more little hammer-offs and pull-ons that Coxon put on the original recording, which you can sort of nail down and find for yourself. But that's it, a little bit of practice along the record and you definitely nail it. And it's a great, great tune. It's a good one to knock your mates out with. So get practicing. And I'll see you on stage. Okay, take care.